Hello dear students and a very good morning to all of you. I am here with the social science classes for class 8 and today I am going to start the geography part. We are going to learn chapter number 8 of geography, that is some comparative case studies part 1. Students, this chapter is in relation with the chapter number 7 of geography, that is major industries. That means in this chapter we are going to learn the comparative study of the major industries of whole world. Okay, so here in this chapter we are going to learn about four major industries of the world, and we will also learn that what are the factors that encourage these industries, or what are the factors that encourage the development of these industries in the world. Okay, so let's have a look on the content that what we are going to learn. So in the first part I am going to provide you the explanation of Tata Iron and Steel Industry, okay, and Detroit, the auto capital of the world. So in this chapter we are going to learn about four industries. The third one is IT industry Bangalore, and the fourth one is IT industry of the Silicon Valley, that is in California. So here in first part I am only going to explain you the TISCO, that is Tata Iron and Steel Industry, and we will learn about Detroit, the auto capital of the world. In the second part I will provide you about the IT industry of Bangalore and about the IT industry of Silicon Valley. Okay, so let us start with the TISCO, that is Tata Iron and Steel Industry. So students, I have already explained you about TISCO in history part, but let us revise it once again. Okay, here we are going to learn about TISCO in the geographical aspect. Okay, so basically as you can see in the picture, this is TISCO. In history we have already learned about TISCO, that TISCO stands for Tata Iron and Steel Industry, and this industry is the oldest and the first iron and steel manufacturing industry of India that was set up by Jamshedji Tata in 1907. Okay, this industry was set up during the colonial era in India, and at that time even the British government also provides support to the establishment of this industry. Okay, so basically this is the look of the particular city or the area where this industry is located. Okay, so first of all we will learn about the location of this industry. As I have explained you, TISCO is the oldest and the first iron and steel manufacturing industry of India. We can also say that first iron and steel manufacturing modern industry in India, in which iron and steel was manufactured with the help of machineries. It was started by Jamshedji Tata in 1907, and this industry is located in Sakshi. Okay, this industry is located at a place known as Sakshi in Singhbhum district of Jharkhand. Okay, or later on this place was named on name of Jamshedji, and it was, that area was known as, is known as Jamshedpur now. Okay, so Jamshedpur is a famous industrial region in Jharkhand, since in Jamshedpur, Tata Iron and Steel Industry is situated, and due to that only, since iron and steel industry is the feeder industry or the basic industry, it provides raw material to the other industry. So Jamshedpur become the industrial hub, okay, or the industrial region where lots of industries are established together, okay, just because the availability of iron and steel. Now let us move further and have a look on the map of India where the Jamshedpur is located. As you can see here, this is the location of Jamshedpur, and as you can see Jamshedpur, there is Kolkata is also there. Okay, downwards Odisha is there. Okay, so these are the places that are located nearby to the Jamshedpur. Okay, now let us move further, and here you can see the location of Tata Iron and Steel Industry. Every one of you are knowing that in 7th chapter when I was explaining major industry, at that time also I have explained you that the whenever a person wants to establish an industry, he or she has to keep several things in mind or several factors in mind. Okay, so as you can see here, the location of Tata Iron and Steel Industry, so this area is surrounded by two rivers. One is Subarnarekha River and the next river is Kharkhai River. As you can see in this picture, this is Subarnarekha River and this is Kharkhai River. Okay, and this is the Tata Iron and Steel Industry. As you can see here, you can take the help of key and you can see here the orange lines are the mark of the roadway network, and here you can see Tatanagar railway station. So that indicates the railway line. Okay. So as you can see, this area is having a dense network of roadways, as well as there is railways facilities are also available here. So let us move further. I hope all of you are able to understand the location of Tata Iron and Steel Industry. Okay, it is located in Sakshi. Okay, the district is Singhbhum, and that district is located in Jharkhand. Okay, now move further. Now, as all of us have already learned about this, that there are several factors that affect the location of any industry. So those factors are available of raw materials, because every industry is based on raw materials, because in industries raw materials are only modified or manufactured in the form of final products. Transportation, all of you are knowing that transportation also plays an important role for the supply of raw material as well as for the supply of the manufactured goods. Okay, next is power supply. The machineries that are running in the industry that needs power, whether it is conventional or non-conventional power, whether it is electricity, thermal power, okay, or coal, petroleum, all these things. So every industry needs power supply also. Labor, every industry needs human labor. Human labor is also of two type. The one is skilled labor and the other is unskilled labor. Now government support, as we have learned in the 7th chapter, that government support is also very important for the development of any industry, because many a times government provides land grants to the industries, as well as the provisions of the marketing system. Okay, the government provides market also. Okay, government provide other help like capital investment. Okay, all these things to the industries. Okay, demand and market, all of you are knowing that every industry has need a good market for selling the manufactured goods. So for that only it is very important ki wherever the industry is established, there should be a great demand of that particular product. Suppose that here in Gorakhpur we are going to establish a cotton industry, so there should be demand for cotton cloth. Okay, then only the industry will develop, then only the products that the industry is manufacturing will be able to sell. Okay, so let us see, we will learn that how these factors plays an important role in the development of TISCO. So first of all, we are learning about availability of raw materials. So all of you are knowing that the raw materials that are required in the manufacturing of iron and steel are iron ore, coal, limestone and manganese. Okay, so from where this place, or from where TISCO got iron supplies? So TISCO got iron from Mayurbhanj and Kendujhargarh places in Odisha. Okay, so from where iron ore came to TISCO power plant? So basically it came from Kendujhargarh and Mayurbhanj. Okay, now and Singhbhum in Jharkhand. So from all these places iron ore is supplied to TISCO. Now coal, Rani Ganj and Jharia coal fields of West Bengal provides coal to this place. Limestone is supplied from Gangapur in Odisha, and manganese also come from Kendujhargarh in Odisha. So all these provide a regular supply of raw materials to the industry. Okay, now next one is transport system. So this place has an ideal location in terms of transport network, as I have shown you in the previous picture only. This place is having a good network of roadways, as well as it is also connected with the help of railways. This place is located just 240 km away from Kolkata, and it also lies on railway line, okay, or railway line of that connected Howrah, Nagpur and Mumbai. So with the help of railways also, the manufactured goods are transported to various places. Okay, as well as the Kolkata port also facilitates exports. That means with the help of Kolkata port, the seaport, okay, the manufactured goods are sold to various places. Now power and water supply. So from where it got power? So students, since TISCO is a very old industry and it is a very large industry, that is why the TISCO owners own their own power plants. Okay, TISCO has its own coal-fired thermal plant also. It is having its thermoelectric plant also. And हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज सप्लाइड टू टिस्को फ्रॉम द दामोदर वैली कॉर्पोरेशन फ्रॉम द दामोदर रिवर देर इज अ मल्टीपर्पज प्रोजेक्ट दैट प्रोवाइड्स हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू दिस प्लेस. इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट वाटर सप्लाई, सो इन द पिक्चर ओनली आई हैव शोन यू दैट दिस एरिया इज सराउंडेड बाई टू रिवर्स, वन इज सुबर्णरेखा रिवर एंड द अदर इज खारखाई रिवर. सो बोथ दीज रिवर प्रोवाइड्स अ गुड वाटर सप्लाई टू दिस इंडस्ट्री. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज गवर्नमेंट सपोर्ट. सो बोथ, सिंस दिस इंडस्ट्री वॉज एस्टैब्लिश ड्यूरिंग द ब्रिटिश एरा, सो ब्रिटिशर्स ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट टू द ओनर ऑफ दिस इंडस्ट्री एज वेल एज द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग सपोर्ट. सिंस टाटा आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री इज अ प्राइवेट इंडस्ट्री, दैट मीन्स इट इज ओन्ड बाय अ प्राइवेट इंडिविजुअल. ओके, बट आफ्टर दैट ऑल्सो गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड्स कैपिटल, ओके, एंड प्रोवाइड्स लैंड ग्रांट ऑल्सो टू दिस एट लो प्राइजेस. ओके, गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड एडिक्वेट कैपिटल फॉर दिस कैपिटल, दैट मीन्स सिंस गवर्नमेंट इज ऑल्सो नोइंग दैट टिस्को इज अ वेरी लार्ज प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ आयरन एंड स्टील, दैट इज वाई गवर्नमेंट सपोर्ट टिस्को. नाउ इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट डिमांड and market, so all of you are knowing that iron and steel industry is the basic industry, that means almost every industry required iron and steel for the manufacturing of different products. Okay, so since iron and steel industry is located near Chota Nagpur Plateau, all of you are knowing that Chota Nagpur Plateau is known as the mineral pocket of India, that means it is a place where every type of minerals are available. Okay, that is the mineral pocket of India where all type of minerals are available. So basically, since every type of raw material is available there, that is why iron and steel industry is established there. As since iron and steel industry is established there, the Chota Nagpur Plateau is the hub of lots of industries. Those industries depend upon TISCO for the supply of raw materials. So basically, TISCO lies in Chota Nagpur Plateau region, which is a hub of industries that creates a high demand for iron and steel. So this is all for the TISCO, that we have learned about the factors that are responsible or that have encouraged the development of TISCO. Okay, now we are going to learn about Detroit, that is the auto capital of the world. Now, why it is known as the auto capital of the world? Because Detroit is the city that manufacture a large variety of automobile. You all are very well familiar about the Ford company, Chrysler company, about the General Motors. The Ford company is the first company of automobile that established in Detroit. Otherwise, the city Detroit was known for basically the manufacturing of the railway coaches and wagons. But later on, when Ford, the owner of the Ford company came here, he established a small automobile industry here, and later on it became a largest automobile manufacturing company. Okay, so let us see. Here you can see that we are going to learn about Detroit. So why Detroit is known as the auto capital of the world? Because it is the largest producer of automobiles. Now let's learn about the location. So basically Detroit is located in USA. Okay, but let us see the location of Detroit. You can see in the map, it is located between Lake Huron and Lake Erie. As you can see here, let me zoom it. As you can see here, this is Detroit, okay? And here you can see this is Lake Erie. And here you can see this is Lake Huron, okay? So it is located between, or it is surrounded by Lake Huron and Lake Erie. And Detroit is located in the Michigan state of USA, okay? Detroit is located in Michigan state of USA, and as you can see here it is Lake Michigan. Lake Michigan is here. This is Lake Michigan, and here you also you can see, wait for a minute, here it is Lake Superior. Okay, here it is Lake Superior. So all these, the water supply is very good near Detroit. Okay, so if someone asks you about the location of Detroit, your simple answer will be Detroit is located in the Michigan state of USA. Okay, and it is also surrounded by Lake Huron and Lake Erie. So Lake Huron and Lake Erie are the supplier of the raw materials also. Let us see further. Now, Detroit is famous for its... So as I have explained you that why Detroit is known as auto capital of the world, because it is the largest manufacturing of automobile. Or we can say that here, major industries of the automobiles are located. But it is also known for the manufacturing of iron and steel. That is, Detroit is also famous for iron and steel industries. Okay, so as you can see, Detroit is famous for the major automobile giants are established in Detroit, that is Ford, Chrysler and General Motors. Okay, this is the headquarter of Chrysler's. Okay, this is the headquarter of Chrysler's. This is the headquarter of Ford in Detroit and this is the headquarter of General Motors in Detroit. Okay, now let us see further. Now this place follows, or Detroit or the automobile industries of Detroit follow the assembly line method for the production. So students, wherever the production is in mass, that means the industries that manufacture, that provides mass production. Okay, so those industries usually follow assembly line production method. Assembly line production method means every work is divided, okay, and workers are divided, and the work is divided into sequence and are connected. Might be all of you have seen in Discovery. On Discovery, all of you have seen that how the manufacturing of everything, you have seen that manufacturing of pencil colors, manufacturing of toffees, you have seen that how every work is divided. So that is only known as assembly line production. Okay, so basically it is a process in which manufacturing processes break down into smaller steps. Okay, and every process is, we can say that responsibility of workers are divided, and a group of workers are responsible for every small steps. Okay, and assembly lines are the most commonly used method in the mass production of products. Okay, now let us see. Now I want to give you an example. All of you have gone for pizzas. Okay, we have gone for the pizza in the Domino's or wherever. Okay, or we have ordered for the pizza delivery. Okay, have all of you are knowing that they have the commitment of delivering the pizza in just 30 minutes. Okay, so how they are successfully able to manufacture or to deliver this pizza to you in just 30 minutes? Because they follow a proper manufacturing method for the production of pizzas. Okay, so basically work is divided into sequences. First of all, there is someone who will receive the order. Okay, now there is someone who is preparing the dough. Dough preparation is given to someone. Now adding ingredients, one worker is there to add ingredients. Place pizza in oven. So there is another worker who is placing pizza in order. Assembly pizza box. There is someone who is assembling the pizza box after the baking. Okay, after that, content verification, that whatever you have ordered is packed or not. After that, delivery bag preparation, wherever the delivery bag, the pizza is packed into delivery bag, and someone else is hired for the purpose of delivery process. So like this, only work is divided into assembly line. Every work is divided into sequence and it is allocated to different workers so that it can be done on time. Okay, now let us move further. Availability of raw materials. Here we are going to learn about that what are the factors that encourage the development of Detroit as the auto capital of the world. So first of all, availability of raw materials. So here also, iron ore comes from Mesabi Range on the shores of Lake Superior. I have shown you in the map that where is Lake Superior. On the north left side, I have shown you Lake Superior. There Mesabi Range is there. From there, iron ore came to the Detroit. Coal is brought from the North and Middle Appalachian fields. North and Middle Appalachian coal fields, coal brought to that place. Limestone is quarried from the island in Lake Erie and Huron. Limestone is brought from the lakes, Lake Erie and Lake Huron. Okay? Now, let us come to the transportation. So, transportation system means the Great Lake and St. Lawrence. These two lakes, the St. Lawrence Seaway and Great Lake, serve as an excellent means of water support. Okay, so these two lakes provide a good medium of water transport to this place. A dense network of road and rail routes adds to easy and cheap transportation. Since Detroit has a very good network of road as well as a very good network of railways that provides cheap as well as easy transportation. Okay, now Atlantic ports provide एडवांटेज फॉर एक्सपोर्ट्स एंड इम्पोर्ट्स. अटलांटिक पोर्ट मीन्स ऑल ऑफ यू आर नोइंग दैट अटलांटिक ओशन इज द बिजिएस्ट ओशन. दैट मीन्स द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ दैट प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर मेड इन डेट्रॉइट टू द वेरियस कंट्रीज. ओके, सो दैट इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑफ द अटलांटिक पोर्ट. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज पावर एंड वाटर सप्लाई. सो इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट पावर सप्लाई, सो फॉर द पावर सप्लाई नियाग्रा फॉल इज देयर दैट प्रोवाइड्स हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू दिस प्लेस. नियाग्रा फॉल प्रोवाइड्स अ रेगुलर सप्लाई ऑफ हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू डेट्रॉइट. इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट वाटर सप्लाई, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट लेक सुपीरियर इज देयर, लेक ह्यूरॉन इज देयर, लेक एरी इज देयर. सो ऑल दीज लेक्स प्रोवाइड अ गुड सप्लाई ऑफ वाटर टू दिस प्लेस. ओके, नाउ लेट अस थिंक अबाउट लेबर. सो स्टूडेंट्स इन जमशेदपुर और इन टिस्को दैट ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड लेबर, एंड लेबर इज ब्रॉड फ्रॉम द नियर बाय रीजन्स ऑफ दैट प्लेस, लाइक फ्रॉम वेस्ट बंगाल, फ्रॉम उड़ीसा. इन इंडिया और इन जमशेदपुर द लेबर कॉस्ट इज वेरी लेस. वेरी लेस नहीं, इज लेस इन कंपेरिजन टू डेट्रॉइट. ओके, सो बेसिकली इन डेट्रॉइट स्किल्ड लेबर इज अवेलेबल इन द नियर बाय रीजन्स. फ्रॉम द नियर बाय रीजन्स ओनली द लेबरर्स केम टू डेट्रॉइट फॉर वर्किंग इन द स्टील iron and steel industry as well as in the automobile industry. But the labor cost is high in Detroit in comparison to the Tisco company. Okay, so basically since the labor cost is high, so it added to the production cost. That is why the price of the product increases. Okay, now let us move further. Demand and market. All of you are knowing that Detroit is known for the automobile company. So Detroit is the center of iron and steel industry, that is the feeder industry, as well as Detroit is the center of various other industries like automobile, engineering, spare parts where the parts of the automobiles manufactured, as well as the defense equipments are also manufactured in Detroit. So are you able to understand that all these industries, the automobile industry, the engineering industry, spare part, as well as the defense equipment industries required a large amount of iron and steel. Okay, and from there only, from Detroit's iron and steel industry only, these demands are fulfilled. That means there is a very good demand. These industries created demand for iron and steel. Okay, the automobile manufactured in Detroit has a demand in US, Asia and other countries. As we have seen that this place, since automobiles Ford, Chrysler and General Motors are a very reputed brand and are the automobile giants that manufactured, and their automobiles are very great in demand in the other parts of the world. Okay, so that is why Detroit is successful, because the automobiles that it produced are supplied to other countries like US. In US also it is very great in demand, as well as in Asia and other countries. Okay, so this is why Detroit is also stabled as a successful automobile industry in whole world. So these I have explained you, these two industries, Tisco as well as Detroit. Now tomorrow I am going to explain you about the IT industry of Bangalore and Silicon Valley. Okay, one is in India and one is in California, USA. Okay, so this is all for today. Please read the chapter. This chapter is more for reading. Okay, I have taken out the major points from this chapter and I have explained you, but you will be able to understand more when you will read this chapter. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you, students.